Hi, if you're watching this video, you've probably purchased a package of Untamed Feast Wild Mushrooms. We're going to be showing you how to prepare some of these dishes today. We are in the French Mint Cooking School in Victoria, BC, which is a beautiful space. And there's a few recipes inside each package. We're going to go over on how to cook at least one recipe out of these packages. And what you're going to need to do it, it's pretty quick, it's pretty easy. You don't have to be a five-star chef to do this. The idea is for you to do this at home. Why would you use dried mushrooms versus fresh mushrooms? Different application. Fresh is great for presentation. Dried for soups, sauces, gravies, risottos, has way more intensified flavor. Very different. So let's get started. In this segment, we're gonna cook some porcini risotto with these gorgeous BC porcini wild mushrooms. Porcini is very different in flavor from morel. And different again from our blend, which is a blend of chanterelle and morel and porcini, really nice fusion. But let's talk about the porcini. So first thing to do, open up your package and have a smell. It's a very aromatic, very concentrated smell and flavor. And it has, it's the umami flavor, the umami taste. There's much more flavor in this dried and concentrated than there is in the fresh porcini. When you make a soup, a sauce, a gravy, a risotto, very important to use this dried product. Fresh is nice, dried more flavor. Okay? So you can take your recipe out of the package, assemble your ingredients, and we'll be going from there. Alright, so the first step is to take your mushrooms and rehydrate them. Now, you're going to take a cup and a half of water, add it to the contents of your package. These are beautiful BC wild grown mushrooms. They're clean. Add your cup and a half of water to that. And just give them a little stir just so that everything gets some water on it. And that's gonna rehydrate soap for about 20 minutes. So you can put that aside while you assemble your other ingredients, open your bottle of wine, and let's get going. Okay, so as your mushrooms are soaking, you need to prepare your stock. You can use a vegetable stock or a chicken stock, and you're going to need to add that in intervals to your risotto while you're stirring it. We're going to get into that, but it needs to be warm. So using the recipe, create about 4 or 5 cups of chicken or vegetable stock. Then we're going to start by sauteing our onions and garlic. So you can add 1 tablespoon of butter and about 4 tablespoons of olive oil. You don't have to put the butter in here. I think that's about 4. But if you mainly use olive oil with a little bit of butter, you're going to get that nice butter flavor. So put in your 1 cup of onions. And we've got 3 cloves of minced garlic. Okay, you're just going to stir this. You're going to make it transparent, not brown, so just coat the onions and garlic really nice. That should take about 3 or 4 minutes. Okay, so now we're at the stage where our mushrooms have rehydrated, our beautiful BC porcini mushrooms. You can just take them out of the bowl, give them a gentle squeeze just to get that moisture out, and put them on your cutting board. We're going to dice them up and add them in with our onions and garlic. Let's chop these up. Again, if you like big chunks, make big chunks. If you like small pieces, go with small pieces. I like to do a fairly small piece over a large piece. And you're going to add this in to your onions. We'll give that about 5 minutes or so to saute up in the next. You have to save this broth in soaking water. It has a lot of the flavor in it, and you're going to use this as part of your stock in the risotto. This is the beauty of a dried mushroom being concentrated in flavor. When you rehydrate it, you're not losing any of that flavor because you're going to keep this water. It takes about 11 to 12 pounds of fresh porcini to make 1 pound of dried porcini. So you're getting a 10 to 1 concentration of flavor. Okay, so our porcini and onions are starting to golden up really nice. It's really fragrant and heady. The pan is ready now for us to add the rice and start coating the rice. Before we do that, let's take our mushroom soaking water and add that to the stock. That's gonna bring more mushroom flavor. So I've got 1 cup of arborio rice, which is an Italian style rice. It's a really starchy rice you can use. There's something more common called cow rose. It'll work, but if you can find arborio, that's what you're looking for. Add that in, 1 cup, and then stir it in. And what you're doing here is you're coating the rice with the oil, and make sure you stir it around and get everything coated. You can leave the heat where it is, because a little bit of toasting of rice is pretty nice. I'm starting to smell that already. So give that a good stir. And now we're going to begin by adding 1 ladle at a time of our stock, our mushroom and vegetable, our mushroom and chicken stock, and letting the rice absorb. Okay, so at this stage we're going to add some wine. When you're cooking with mushrooms, wine is really nice. It also, it's a really easy pairing. Whatever you're cooking with, feel safe about pairing that with the meal. We're making a risotto, we're using some white wine. Serve a glass of white wine with it, the same one you used. We have our stock ready, so we give that wine a quick stir in. Everything's starting to get coated here. We're going to add our first ladle of stock. Now the idea with risotto is to add little bits at a time, keep the heat up, and keep stirring it. It's not a dish you walk away from, it's a dish you have fun with. So pour yourself a bottle or a glass of wine, and not a whole bottle. And carry on with the process. As this absorbs, we'll add more. The old Italian ladies would say that the spoon has to stand up before you add more. This spoon's a bit big, but that gives you a bit of a perspective of how absorbed you want it to be. It's starting to clump. You want it to burn, it's time for another ladle. In total, you're going to use about 4 cups of stock. But sometimes you need a little bit more, sometimes you need a little bit less. The only way you're going to know when this is done is by tasting. But it's still going to be 10 to 15 minutes at least, and about 4 cups of broth. We are about halfway through the risotto here. We've added about half our stock. And I have some rice, some risotto rice, so this is what you're looking for. This is arborio style rice. You can get this in Victoria at a few stores, specialty shops. If you're in Vancouver, I know Bosa Foods carries it. But even in Safeway, bigger places, look for arborio style rice. So keep stirring that in. It takes a while. Be patient. Enjoy the process. Now the rice has picked up most of our stock. As I mentioned, the way you're going to test that is by taking, you have to take a little bit. You don't want it to be too soft. It's delicious, it's mushroomy, and the rice is slightly al dente. Final step to a great risotto is the cheese. Parmigiano Reggiano, which is real Parmesan cheese. It should come in a hard square like this. You can find it just about any grocery store. Unless you're extremely stuck, don't use the powdered stuff that comes in the shaker. That's not what Parmesan cheese is. So just grate yourself up some. You need 4 tablespoons for this recipe. Just go ahead and put that in there. And this is where the risotto gets really creamy. Stir that in. I've turned the heat off now at this point. If you want to, and you're okay with a few extra gorgeous calories, add another tablespoon of butter at this point. That's really gonna add to the creaminess of the dish. This is a very comforting food. you like starch and comfort, you're gonna love this. I love it. And that's all you need to do. So let's serve this up. This was the recipe from one package of the Orgini, and it's easily gonna serve 3 or 4 people. Gonna give you fuel for running around picking mushrooms in the bush for a long time. There's lots of calories in there. Alright, a little bit of garnish. Again, you can put on a touch of fleur de sel, sea salt is nice. And some parsley is beautiful on there. And that's it. You have a wild mushroom porcini risotto that serves 3 to 4 people, done in your home. It's about 20 minutes. The great thing about our products is not only can you cook great recipes with these wild mushrooms, but you can watch them being harvested. You can go to our website. I have informative videos there, adventure videos. You can learn about how the mushrooms grow and what it takes to get this amazing food onto your plate. So join us at untamedfeast.com.